వెల్కమ్ బ్యాక్. రాజ్యసభలో సమావేశాలు కొనసాగుతున్నాయి, లైవ్ ద్వారా చూద్దాం.
It may be worth bottling if we were to go back to history. We'd find that the Spanish flu epidemic which took place at the end of World War I led to about 50 million deaths, and of which most of it was contributed by the second wave. Now I think so I think it's quite clear now that what we are facing is a long drawn struggle. We are facing something akin to a prolonged war, and this prolonged war is something which is not only something which is not something which affects only India.
Please go back to this.
Which affects?
Please go back to this, Mr. Vijay Sarathy. This is not a proper behaviour. You are a seasoned and senior member. This is not proper behaviour.
I think I may be right in saying
this is completely
unparliamentary behavior. How do we deal with such a pandemic? And I think the answers are not necessarily easy. It's not necessarily easy. If I may start by saying so, if I may quote a line, so it is rather difficult and distracting to talk over this. I think all the same I'll try. I think a lot of us may be aware, or at least those, my friend Mr. O'Brien there might be aware of the passage I might be reading, because the author of that passage is someone who the state government of West Bengal appointed in the Global Advisory Board to contain the pandemic. And I quote, "The goal of social policy in these times of change and anxiety is to help people absorb the shocks that affect them without allowing those shocks to affect their view of themselves." In other words, how do we cope with the crisis without destroying the very esteem of people who've been affected by the crisis? This is a quote from the Nobel Prize winning Abhijit Banerjee. I think when we, in terms of social policy, have to decide, it's basically we have to take a balance of risks. That is what it's all choice in this matter. Policy is always about. It's about how do we balance the various risks at play. There is, of course, one way of just saying to seal off yourself from the rest of the world. Some of you may remember the case of Sir Isaac Newton, who in the time of the Great Plague shut himself off in a village for 3 years and produced some of his best and most creative works. Alas, that is a luxury I think we can ill afford today. I think we have to decide how much pain we can endure and how much relief we can give to people. I think when we decide that lockdown is only a temporary strategy, we take into account the fact.
నర్సాపురం ఎంపీ రఘురామకృష్ణరావు